Dotsu's Orichalcos deck. If you want to see this deck in action, then stick around to the end of the video for the dual replays. But this is my upgraded version of Dotsu's Orichalcos deck, which he used at the end of Season 4 of the Yu-Gi-Oh! Anime. So let's check this out.
What?
His deck! You know, man, his deck. We all got decks. You got a deck, I got a deck. Hell, I can whip out my deck right now and show you.
No. Please don't. I'll just trust that it's there.
For this deck, there are three main strategies to follow. The first is the obvious Orichalcos Gygas and Orichalcos Qtora. If you combine this with the Seal of Orichalcos field spells, then you have an almost unbreakable field. Your Gygas will keep reviving and your Qtora will keep absorbing the damage you take from battles. Furthermore, with the effect of the Seal of Orichalcos, you can put Orichalcos Qtora into your spell and trap card zone, meaning he won't be able to be attacked while your Gygas is on the field. Then, once Qtora is destroyed, of course you can go into your Orichalcos Shunaros, who gains attack equal to the amount of damage absorbed by Qtora, and he will then summon Orichalcos Dexia and Orichalcos Aristoros. These cards are basically always stronger than any monster that they battle, with Aristoros having 300 higher defense than the attack of the monster attacking it, and Dexia having 300 higher attack than the attack or defense of the monster that it is attacking. Once Shunaros is destroyed, of course, you can pay 10,000 life points to summon Divine Serpent, who will then reduce your life points to zero, discard your entire hand, and you won't be able to lose the duel. Also, its attack points are infinity. This whole strategy works really well when we combine it with the trap card all-out attacks. This card will force special summon monsters to switch to attack position, and they must attack the turn that they're summoned if able. This works really well against a lot of OTK decks, as it will force your opponent's monsters to attack your Gygas, and your Qtora will then absorb all of the damage, which will not only strengthen your Gygas, but also strengthen Shunaros when it hits the field. All Out Attacks is a fantastic card in this deck, as there is basically no time that we don't want our opponent to attack. Like, unless we have no monsters, we want our opponent attacking pretty much. Because all of our monsters are really strong and just stop everything. Like, there is no downside to having our opponent attack, which is why it also works really good with Orichalcos Mirror. This is the second strategy in the deck. Mirror Knight Calling can be summoned with the ritual spell Orichalcos Mirror. This card can be used to summon Mirror Knight Calling from your hand or your deck, which means it works extremely well with pre-preparation of rites. With pre-preparation of rites, you can add a ritual spell plus its ritual monster from your deck to your hand. That means you can get your Orichalcos Mirror and your Mirror Knight Calling, and then use your Orichalcos Mirror to tribute the Mirror Knight Calling in your hand and special summon the Mirror Knight Calling that is left over in your deck. You can then recycle it with this awesome link monster that I found, Dynamondo. This card is not only a fantastic removal which we can summon during our opponent's turn, but it will also recycle our Mirror Knight Calling to then use again. Now, when Mirror Knight Calling is summoned, it will summon 4 Mirror Knight tokens. These Mirror Knight tokens can be used for all sorts of things. For one thing, their attack points become equal to the attack of the monster that they're battling, meaning it works extremely well with all out attacks. They can't be destroyed while they have a shield counter on them, and the Mirror Knights will protect each other from attacks as well. So as long as you have Mirror Knight Calling on the field, these monsters become basically an indestructible field, but also Mirror Knight Calling is a one card Link 5 monster, right? This card can be used with its Mirror Knights to go into all sorts of Link plays. Now, if you want to see our main Link combo with this deck, then be sure to stick around to check out the second duel of the dual replays. The final strategy with this deck is our Divine Serpent OTK. There are two main lines that we can use to summon Divine Serpent in one turn. The first requires a little bit of setup, and that is using Trap Tracks. This card is actually really good for the deck. So what we can do with Trap Tracks is use its effect to destroy the Qtora on our field. Qtora will then be used to summon Orichalcos Shunaros. Then you can use Trap Tracks' effect once Qtora is destroyed to set Metaverse from your deck. Metaverse can then be used to easily search out your Orichalcos Shunaros, which is needed to gain life points for the 10,000 life point cost of Shunaros' effect. Once you've got that, you've got your 10,000 life points, you've got Shunaros on the field, you can then go into one of your Nightmare monsters, use them to pop one of our opponent's cards, and then go into Abyss Actor's Super Producer, using one of your nightmares as it needs a fiend monster. Abyss Actor Super Producer can then be used to destroy your Orichalco Shunaros with its effect, who will then allow you to pay 10,000 life points to go into the infinite attack, Divine Serpent. Once Divine Serpent is out, just attack for game. As long as your opponent has any attack position monster or even just no monsters, you've won the game. It doesn't matter how many life points they have or how much attack they have. This card, it's infinite attack, right? You win. You win, okay? Duel's over. You've won. The one downside of Divine Serpent is that once it leaves the field, you will lose the duel, meaning some protection is, of course, very important. You will need your Infinite Impermanence to negate your opponent's monster's effects and hopefully negate their spells and traps, but in case of emergencies, you can also use Orichalco's Tritos, the third layer of the seal, to stop your opponent's spell and trap cards. Now, there is one other line that we can use to get Divine Serpent on our very first turn, though it requires a few more cards, but it is very much definitely possible in this deck to summon Divine Serpent on your first turn, and if going second, to win right then and there. If you want to see that combo, then stick around till the end of the video. The last things we need to talk about are the extra cards that I added to this deck. Obviously, there are all the Link monsters. We have some very powerful Link monsters, as well as an extremely strong Link combo that we can go off of with just Orichalco's Mirror. If you want to see that, again, check out the dual replays. The other cards we need to look at are, of course, Nibiru. This card wins games on its own. Orichalco's Diablos can be used to switch our opponent's monsters to attack position, which works extremely well with our Divine Serpent. And I have added a few extra traps. Since Trap Tracks is a really good card in this deck, I thought it would be best to add a few extra normal traps to support this card's effect. This card can be used to set any normal trap from our deck. One card in particular that I need to talk about is Card of Last Will. This card is actually used by Marek in the anime and allows us to draw until we have 5 cards in our hand and can be activated when the attack of one of our monsters changes. Our monster's attack points are constantly changing. Gygas' attack changes by its own effect. Aristoros, Dexia, and Shunaros, their attack changes anytime they attack. Our Mirror Knights, summoned by Mirror Knight Calling, also change their attack anytime they attack one of our opponent's monsters. And of course, as long as we have an Orichalco's field spell, anytime one of our monsters is placed on the field, it gains 500 attacks. So pretty much anytime, at any moment, this card will always be live, allowing us to draw up to 5 cards. That's all we really need to talk about this deck. Now, let's see it in action. Yugi! Are?
Jounouji!
あいぼう、奪われた魂の。相棒、待ちかねたよ。名もなきファラオ、セト。ダーツ、ようこそ我が神殿へ。感じるぞ、強き魂。お前たちに特別席を用意してやる。
これ以上無益な戦いはやめろ。捉えた魂を解放するんだ。デュエルとは元来、古の魂をかけた戦いの儀式。我々もその習いに従うとしよう。ならば貴様の相手は俺だ。いやカイバ、こいつだけはお前一人に任せるわけにはいかない。
ならばまとめて魂を捧げる。ファラオ、セト。
私のターン。漆黒の闇より生まれし神。我が手に天命の力を。来たか。俺怒りこそが結界。
オレイカルコスギガース。さらに私は自分のライフを削り、オレイカルコスキトラを特殊召喚。これで私のターンは終わりだ。
のライフが減っていない。
オレイカルコス・キトラーの特殊能力、それはモンスターのバトルによって発生するダメージをゼロにする力。復活せよオレイカルコス・ギガオス。
気をつけろカイバー、あのモンスターは復活のために攻撃力も増加する。
私のターン。私はオレイカルコスギガースの効果により新たなカードをドローすることはできない。そしてオレイカルコスギガース、マスターオブドラゴンナイトを攻撃せよ。オレイカルコスキトラ効果発動。私にダメージはない。 ルより生まれし第二の力、オレイカルコスデウテロス。これぞ我が最強のしもべ、オレイカルコス・シノロスの攻撃力がゼロになった時、1万以上のライフと全ての手札を捧げ特殊召喚される。ライフポイント、私のライフは消滅し、ゲーが破壊された時私の敗北となる。しかしその攻撃力、
攻撃力無限大。
オレイカルコスの結界、その真の力を見届け、我が神の生贄となるがよい。発動せよ、オレイカルコス第三の結界、オレイカルコストリトス。私はデッキより10枚のカードを捨て、邪神ゲーの攻撃を発動。インフィニティエンド。これで全てが終わり、また新たな歴史が始まる。